Hello, this is Chris Roll, senior editor with mp38.com, and the woman next to me needs very little introduction, but you are Mandy Moore.
I am.
You are.
Sometimes.
I hope you didn't forget that.
No. I'm remembering that lately.
Yeah, lately.
Lately.
I'm sure a lot. We're here to talk about, well, you, and more specifically, your new album and the process involved in creating that album. You chose to put this album out yourself. I mean, not yourself. You didn't actually...
Physically. I'm not actually putting it out under...
No, but you made a decision to steer clear of your relationship with, I believe, Warner Brothers.
Mm-hmm.
And to go with your management team and to release this album.
Yes.
So maybe you could talk about why and how that decision came to be.
Well, to be quite honest, Warner Brothers is not the enemy. I think they expected maybe a more mainstream pop record that would be played on like a top 40 station, which is fantastic and wonderful, but I kind of feel like I've done that, and I've grown up and my musical tastes have changed, and I really wanted that to be reflected in the music that I was writing. And I was very adamant about writing. I was very adamant about the people that I wanted to write with, and I think that's where the discord kind of started. So I amicably left and was on my own for a little bit. Teamed up with John Alasia, who produced my record, and then continued along the path of writing with Lori McKenna and Rachel Yamagata and the Weepies and a lot of like great independent music that I'm a fan of that I don't think I necessarily saw eye to eye with my record label on. But it worked out for everyone because they're Warner Brothers and they're doing just fine, and I eventually got to, you know, make this record, and this record came to fruition exactly the way that I had hoped it would.
When you decided to actually sort of go off the plank, if you will, and do it alone,
mm-hmm.
Did you have any sort of true existential crisis about the artist that you could be when you were forced to be something that presumably you were not in the past?
To be honest, I don't think that much thought went into it. I didn't really overanalyze it. I was like, well, I was signed when I was 15, and even though I'm embarrassed of some of my previous efforts, it was a great platform to start from. It was exactly where I needed to be. And why would anyone at a record label in their right mind allow a 15-year-old to be making creative choices about the music that they should be recording? So I understand that. But now that I'm 23, it only felt natural that I take this progression. And also because I feel like I haven't had tremendous, like, musical success, it really lent itself for me having... No, seriously, I'm just being honest. Like, in the scheme of things, it really allowed me to go off and make whatever kind of record I wanted to, because there was no expectation. There wasn't like this anticipation of like, wow, when's Mandy's next album coming out? Mm-hmm. I mean, maybe by like four or five people, but like, I honestly think it was the best possible situation to be in. Otherwise, I maybe would have been influenced to do something a little bit different and not necessarily completely true to me.
But when you say a small group of people, I mean, I'm talking over 7 million people.
Yeah, but that's like a bunch of records, and that's around the world, and that's, it doesn't, to me, I mean, I'm very grateful that people have bought my music and whatnot, but I think, God, yeah, it doesn't really factor into me.
Okay.
I haven't had the success that other people of my ilk, like artists that came out at the same time, that's all I'm saying.
Right. What about other artists of your ilk, if you bring it up? Because, you know, let's look at some of your peers from the past. We don't need to drop names,
but we've all differentiated ourselves. We've all gone off in our different directions, and everything happens for a reason. And I don't know, for some reason I'm still around and kicking, and people are still interested in my music and stuff. I'm kind of the choices I'm making in my career, so I feel very lucky to be in this position. I've always kind of felt like the underdog, which is a position I feel comfortable in because it's what I've been used to, and I think it pushes me even harder to continue along the path that I've sort of cut out for myself. But it definitely has allowed me a little bit of a grace period that I don't think some of my peers have had, to be able to sit back and make sure that I'm taking the right steps and I'm still having fun and I'm doing everything for the right reasons.
Why did it take you 2 years to flush this album out of your system?
Because I think I was going back and forth between like some film stuff and Entourage and like TV stuff, you know what I mean? So there was a lot of other stuff going on in between, but I would find the downtime and carve out the time actually to like fly to Boston and write with Lori McKenna, and it was all sort of happening at the same time. But once this past summer, like the summer of 2006, like September, I finished writing with the Weepies and I was like, you know what, I'm done. I think I'm ready to finally go into the studio and start like committing this down, you know, to actually make a record. I feel like, to be perfectly honest, I feel like there are some people that won't necessarily give this record a fair shot, which is totally okay, because of me and because of my name and the preconceived notion of the music I've done in the past or who they think I am. And that's a bit of a bummer to me. And it's difficult with like radio too, because this is a song, like the first single, Extraordinary, is not a song that will be played on top 40 radio necessarily. But I think other like cooler radio stations again hear my name and they're like, well, I don't want to play a Mandy Moore song. So there's a part of me that's like, ugh, I should have just released it under like some weird fake pseudonym, or do you know what I mean? Like some band name.
Right.
But
then that would also seem extraordinarily contrived.
Yeah, I know. So at the end of the day, I went with my name.
So you are who you are.
I am who I am. I can't escape it. Nerdy and all. I've always felt authentic because I've sort of been in charge of making all of the decisions in my career. But I've always sort of felt like what you see is what you get. I've always been myself. But I definitely feel like there's been a shift and a change over the last couple of years in terms of not only the roles that I'm offered, but the roles that I'm going after in the film world. And it only felt fitting that the music makes sense in that way too. And that's why I found such a struggle with the label, with Warner Brothers, because I was like, I'm doing a movie with Diane Keaton, and like, the music has to make sense with that too. Like, granted, they're romantic comedies or whatever they may be, but to work with those sorts of credible artists that have had such longevity in their careers, and then to go off and make like a really of-the-moment pop record didn't make sense to me. And I was like, and at the end of the day, like, the music is more me than anything, and that has to speak volumes about who I am. So I definitely feel like I'm in the right place in my life, and I've found a lot of clarity through writing, and I'm still learning, but I feel like that the writing process definitely caught me up over the last couple of years of just sort of being in the thick of not a machine, but just like working sort of back to back to back to back. The music kind of allowed me to sort of step back and catch my breath and figure out, am I doing the right thing? Am I going in the right direction? And am I being the person I want to be? Like all those sort of life-affirming questions.
Well, the album drops June 19th.
Yep.
Yeah, that's exciting.
Yeah. Huh?
And then when do you think you'll actually be out on this tour?
Maybe late summer, early fall.
Okay.
That's what I'm hoping for.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
And thank you for talking
to us. You said that with a question mark, but thank you.
Well, this has been Mandy Moore. And she will continue to be Mandy Moore. And
hopefully.
I will continue to be Chris Rolls. And thank you for tuning in.
Thanks.